Hello and welcome everyone. I'm so glad you could join me for today's video where we will be diving into some of the most common HTML interview questions. Whether you're just starting out in your coding journey or you're a seasoned pro, it's always helpful to be prepared for any interview question that might come your way. And since HTML is such a foundational language for web development, you can bet that you'll encounter plenty of HTML related questions in any technical interview. So if you're ready to boost your HTML knowledge and ace your next interview, you're in the right place. In this coming series of videos, we will be discussing everything from the basics of HTML syntax to more advanced topics such as accessibility and SEO optimization. So sit back, relax, and get ready to level up your HTML skills. Let's dive in. We begin with one of the most simple and basic questions that you might get asked in your interview. That is, what is HTML? So, HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. Essentially, HTML is a programming language that is used to create the structure and content of web pages. When you visit a website, the information you see is displayed in your browser thanks to HTML. HTML is the backbone of the web, allowing web developers to create a wide variety of pages with different layouts, styles, and functionality. HTML uses tags to define different elements of web pages, such as headings, paragraphs, images, links, and more. HTML can be used in conjunction with other programming languages like CSS and JavaScript to create more dynamic and interactive websites. Overall, HTML is a powerful tool for creating web pages, and it's an essential skill for anyone interested in web development or design. The next question in this series is, what are tags? HTML tags are the building blocks of HTML documents. HTML tags are essentially the code used to define and structure different elements of a web page, such as headings, paragraphs, image, links, and more. HTML tags are enclosed in an angle brackets. They usually come in pairs, an opening tag and a closing tag, with the content between the element. For example, the opening tag for paragraph element and the closing tag for paragraph element is shown in the example below. Any content placed between these tags will be formatted as a paragraph on the web page. HTML tags can be nested within each other to create more complex structure. The next question that we will be covering is, are the HTML tags and elements the same thing? This question often confuses many web developers. So, let us dive right into the answer. While the terms are often used interchangeably, they actually refer to the different things in HTML. HTML tags are the markup symbols that are used to define the structure and content of a web page. These tags are placed within angle brackets and they often come in pairs, with an opening tag to begin the element and a closing tag that ends the element. For example, the P tag is used to define a paragraph. It comes with the following opening and closing bracket. I've shown it in this example below. On the other hand, an HTML element is a complete definition of an object on the web page, including the opening tag, the content, and the closing tag. An HTML element can consist of multiple HTML tags, as well as any text, images, or other content that are enclosed within those tags. So while P tag is an individual HTML element, the complete P element is composed of both the opening P tag, the content of paragraph, and the closing P tag. The next question in this list is very common in interviews. What are singleton tags? Singleton tags in HTML are tags that do not require a closing tag. These tags are also known as self-closing tags or void elements. Instead of separate closing tag, the slash is included at the end of opening tag. Singleton tags are used for elements that do not have any content or do not require an end tag. Let's check below the examples of such elements. For example, the image tag is a singleton tag because it is used to insert images into the web page and it does not have any content. The BR tag is also a singleton tag because it is used to create line breaks and it does not have any content or attributes. So, the final question in today's list is, what is doctype declaration in HTML? So, the doctype declaration in HTML is a special HTML tag that informs the web browser about the version of HTML that is being used on a web page. The doctype declaration must be included at the top of an HTML document before any other HTML tags. The HTML doctype declaration is important because it ensures that the web browser displays the web page correctly and in accordance with the HTML specification. Different versions of HTML have different rules and syntax, so it's essential to include the correct doctype declaration for the version of HTML being used. Here is an example of doctype declaration for HTML5. That's it for today's video. Thanks for watching this video on HTML interview questions. I hope you found it helpful and informative. If you enjoyed this video and you would like to see more like it, please let me know in the comments below. I'm always looking for feedback on the content I create, and I want to make sure I'm providing value to my viewers. Also, if you have any suggestions for future topics or questions you'd like me to cover, please feel free to leave those in comments as well. Thank you again for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.